welcome to Chamber Connections. I'm Maureen Sullivan from the Bedford Chamber of Commerce, and today my guest is Linda Stimson from Inner Visions Interiors. Thank you for joining us, Linda.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
So we're going to talk all about color today and what it means in our homes and a little bit in our clothes for me, because I like that. So tell me, first of all, how did you get into interior design?
Well, I was always an art kid. And initially, I went to art school in Manhattan, and then I became an art therapist and worked at the West Roxbury VA as a spinal cord and cardiac rehab therapist, but didn't really fulfill me. So I switched in 1983 to interior design, which involves color and dealing with people and improvisation. And I apprenticed initially, and it just took off like a snap since 1983.
Very good. So for those of you watching, you can see we have all these beautiful color boards, and we're gonna start. We talked a little bit about what color means and how it makes us feel. So let's start with this blue, because I'm a big blue and white person.
Hi, this blue and white board represents a very classic color scheme, classic blue and white. And we have some slides that'll show you different ways we can use it. But blue and white came initially from the China trade into England and France and then to the New World. And it's very calming and soothing and wonderful, unless you have too much of it. And then over time, to liven things up, you can add red, and that makes it very much warmer. Or another way to enliven things is to add a complementary color, which is orange, and that makes everything zing. It's the complementary or opposite color on the color wheel. And this is a very different color scheme now with the introduction of this warm color. But when you choose a color scheme for your house, you want something that you've liked for a very long time, in clothes, colors that you wear, nothing trendy, and something specific that makes you look good and your complexion look good as well. So that's
blue and white. Wait a minute, so if you're like one of those summer, winter, fall, so whatever you are, your house should be, like you'll look better in your house or you'll feel better in your house?
You will look better and be your most beautiful if you surround yourself in colors that make your skin and your complexion look better. Absolutely. And if you check your closet, very often people wear colors that they love the most and have since a very long time. And there's no reason not to look the most beautiful you can in your own home. And surround yourself in your home with wall colors and curtain colors that reflect on your complexion in a positive way.
Okay, so this is really interesting because obviously we don't all live by ourselves. So this board is purple, which is my favorite color, and you can see it looks the best on me. I mean, I am definitely a purple person. I have no purple in my house, which makes me very sad because it's not one of my husband's favorite colors.
This color scheme is representative of youth and energy.
No wonder I like it.
And,
yes.
And strong positive emotions. I'm actually doing two rooms in this color, one for a family with a baby infant girl called Violet.
And the baby's name's Violet?
The baby's name is Violet, and another family who have three little girls. This is a common color scheme in children's, usually girl children's, rooms, and it's brought here from India and Pakistan and the global economy. You see colors in these, you know, rooms in these really wild colors. And this lime green, it's been a trendy color for the past 10 years. Mm-hmm. Would you, someone our age, tend to do their whole house in this color scheme? Most probably not. It's a very youthful board.
Yeah. I just realized my daughter just painted her room, and it's like this dark, maybe even really dark, this color purple.
Right.
So when you do these rooms for Violet and the three little children, are you painting the walls the purple with the complements of the green? I mean, I can't imagine having one of these bedrooms like
this. In one room, which is a family room, playroom, there's very pastel shades of purple and greens on the wall, and then darker amounts of that same purple and green on a ultra suede sectional mm-hmm. that'll be extremely durable for mothers and fathers who have a dog and three little mm-hmm. kids, and a carpet in this purple. But wow. on the wall, much softer versions. And in the little baby's room, the carpet is a deep purple also, but we're painting one room, one wall of the room in a faux tree of life.
Oh, how nice. I want to be Violet. Is that Violet's room?
That's Violet's room.
Oh, I'm coming back as Violet. All right, let's go move on to another color that I like, and that would be this.
You can see I'm like colors.
This, yes.
Okay. This is definitely young and vibrant.
We have a little pattern here.
And exciting and whimsical. This colorway is representative of a family room I'm doing right now. Iridescent pink wallpaper, white silk drapes, a purple sectional with a purple ottoman in front of it, and most of these are pillows. And what you can't get over to on television, but mm-hmm. maybe you could, Maureen, is how soft some of these velvets are.
Right.
That you can actually have very, very durable fabrics. This is a commercial grade velvet that should last for 10 years with 100 people sitting on it every day. And it's one of the softest fibers you can have.
I love these colors, and I can see, like, so if you did a family room in this, but then how do you carry that through in your house? Like, so you have this one vibrant room. I mean, I don't think you could have a whole house that vibrant, or you'd never get to sleep. Like, how do you move from that into, you know, the rest of the house?
In the common rooms of a house, you would change the value of the same color scheme, so using a small amount of one color and then maybe lighter values of the same color throughout the house. But if you want it to be calm and soothing, you might want to use this color scheme, blue and green, which is the color of the sea and sand and relaxation. The good color scheme has three basic colors, a cool color, a neutral color, and a warm color. Most of these colors, the teal and the sand colors, are cool colors. And if you add just a little bit of a warm color, like this peachy pink, it warms the whole mm-hmm. thing up and makes it feel good. Another version of blue and green. Which I did for a young gentleman's room, is here, but it's the same feeling. It's calm and cool and soothing, and people who like this might not like this, but I encourage people to find out what they like themselves, and then we find a way to make what they like and their husband like. Everyone seems to want to get at least something.
Right.
My rule for master bedrooms is that both of the parties have to like it, anything that goes in there. But this is calm and peaceful, and it'll help you relax, and that's what blue and green does.
So is that why, I'm thinking, like most hospitals, they paint those rooms those light...
absolutely. That's right. So this would make a good room for regeneration and recovery, mm-hmm. like a hospital, like a mammography clinic.
Right.
You find will be in these colors because they really do have a physiological reaction. It makes you feel calm and peaceful. And there's a time when any patient walks into any medical setting, they need to feel calm and peaceful.
Right.
And reassured at the same time.
All right, let's go to what I would call boring beige yellow.
Okay.
I'm really trying to start liking these. I'm trying to, what I call these colors, like the Crate and Barrel colors. Like those kind of, a little darker than this, but, you know, they don't have much pizzazz. And I'm trying to like them, but...
These
I'm just not a yellow
colors
person.
Are very cool and soothing. I just did this color board for a doctor who's 78 and his wife who's 75. And one of the reasons we use these really bright and lighter colors is because as you age, you need more light in the room and more lumens provided by electrical light, but also colors absorb light. So if you use much lighter colors, you can see easily. So this was for their indoor-outdoor Florida room. Mm-hmm. And it can be very calm and peaceful, but also the yellow is energizing and the gray turns it down. You don't have to like it. You should just find what you like.
So let me ask you a question about these boards. So these are actual boards. So you as a designer, you come to my house, you're going to design my room. So this, you brought this board to your client's house? Like, did you pick out these colors? Like, you talked to them, they said, okay, we want to do...
Well, I went to their house. They have gray tile mm-hmm. on the floor. I always find out what my client likes, and I do this little exercise. Let's say we're doing a family room. I say, here's a bunch of magazines. Mm-hmm. Find 10 family rooms, regardless of the architecture, that you like. That way, you'll know before you make an investment of time and money and energy and hope that your room's gonna be nice, mm-hmm. you'll know what you're aiming for. You find your goal of what you really like, because people's tastes change every 10 years or so. So they find those rooms and then show me those 10 pictures.
Right.
And once I see those pictures, I know what colors they like. I find out whether they like straight lines or floral patterns. I find out a lot. Because pictures really tell the story.
So these little fabric, do you have like in your house thousands of pieces of fabric that you then put together, or do you go, like, you bring this board back to them after you put it together?
This board was made for educational teaching. I teach mm-hmm. for teaching reasons. When I work with a client, I show fabrics, many, many fabrics, mm-hmm. and then we settle on which okay. ones work. And it's all about me making a partnership with my client and me not allowing them to make a costly error and making the most of what they have. So if they have a small, not that appealing room, mm-hmm. it can turn into a little jewel box.
Right.
In their taste, not right. in my taste.
Right. So let's go to the last board, because the last time we did our show, Madeline had just painted the walls in this room, which okay. I actually love this color. So I want you to tell me what this color, how I'm supposed to feel in here, other than a little hot right now. But and if she's going to do some complementary colors to it, what would they be?
This board evokes feelings of nature, and it's most probably the most common color scheme I've used in the past 30 years. The only thing that's different about this board is that it combines both maroon colors, like you have on the walls, and oranges. Because of global interaction and quick looking all around, we are now doing outrageous color schemes that would have never happened. But over time, people love greens and rusts or burgundies all together. And I've done the majority of color scheme has been this color scheme. What you would vary as the rooms of pictures in this color scheme mm-hmm. would show is the quantity of green versus the quantity of the red tone. Their complements. So one room might have a majority of green. Mm-hmm. And just a touch of red, where you make the flow go into another room, and it could be mostly red with just touches of green. But still, the common colors go through those living room, dining room, entryway, hall, upstairs, and sometimes family room as well.
Well, I've just realized that this is my color scheme in my house, because my living room is that, not quite that green, but that, you know,
sagey green
with my mahogany, leather, whatever. My hallway is like that color, and then my my dining room is that beigey, you know, tanny color.
Like a brown tone.
So I've realized that I've done this without even knowing it, although it's not purple, so I don't love it. But I have to say, people seem to think they're like, oh, I like your color scheme.
So this color scheme is warm, all the red tones. Right. It's rejuvenating and cool because of the green tones, and the neutral would be some shade of beige all the way up to brown.
Right.
So
if Madeline was going to get curtains for in here, what would they be? You know, a printy, like with the green.
Well, you could use a print that had that exact maroon color and some green and some beige.
Right.
You could just go with a green or a beige solid.
This wall is a very popular color. You see, a lot of people do their dining room in this color.
And there's a reason for that. The reason people do their dining room in red tones is because red stimulates the appetite and conversation, and red will reflect back on a woman's complexion and make her look rosy. If you noticed, many restaurants have red walls or some form of red walls, they're stimulating your appetite. Just like you go into a hospital and it's soothing greens or blues, they're trying to calm you down. So every color scheme should not only make your complexion look good, but it can form a mood in the room. Mm-hmm. And you can vary that mood by how much of the warm or cool color you use in the room.
Wow, that's very interesting. This has been great. Better not paint my kitchen then if I'm going to go on a diet.
Yeah, the best color scheme for your kitchen would be whites and blues. Blue, you don't see that many blue foods. You ever see a blue pizza?
No.
No, it's just blueberries, and that's about it. But you don't really want to eat things that are blue. That's usually a good color to paint if you want to lose weight because it's calming and cooling. But you can have a blue kitchen or a blue and white kitchen.
And I have.
And then go into really warmer
next
room, which might be your dining room.
Yeah.
But
awesome.
I warn you, don't do your kitchen with red walls, or you might find that a year later you've gained 20 pounds.
Okay. That's good. That's a really good tip. Well, Linda, thank you very much. This has
been
really interesting. And you can get Linda's information at the Bedford Chamber of Commerce under our directory, Inner Visions Interior.
Thank you so much
for
inviting me.
You're welcome.